Hi friends, welcome back to the new series JavaScript Zero to Hero. In this series, I'm explaining all the basic concepts in JavaScript. In this video, I'm going to talk about loops in JavaScript. Loops are used to repeat a block of code. There are three types of loops available in ES5. They are for loop, while loop, and do while loop. And in ES6, two other loops, for off and for in, got introduced. Let us see an example for each. I can create a for loop like this. This has three parts. In the first part, we need to initialize a helper variable. Mostly we use I. So let me use I equal to 1. After that, I need to have a semicolon to have the second part. And then I need to have my exit condition. That means when to exit from the loop. Let me give I less than or equal to 5. And then a semicolon. And in the final part, we can specify how this I variable needs to be incremented or decremented every iteration. Normally, we can give i++ to increment by 1. But we can also give I equal to i+2 to increment by 2 or any other value. Let me change it back to i++. And let me create the block using curly braces. Inside that, let me print I and execute the code. We can see our code is executed 5 times. The execution starts from here. This part will be executed only one time. And so the variable I will be assigned to 1. And then it will check whether I less than or equal to 5. As I equal to 1, it will be true. And so this code will execute. After this code execution, this third part will execute. And so now I will be incremented to 2. Then it will come to the second part and check whether I is lesser than or equal to 5. And the loop continues. And when I becomes 6, it will check and the second part will be false. And so the execution stops there. Finally, we can see this code is executed 5 times. This is how a for loop works. Let's see an example for while loop. While loop can be created using while keyword followed by a condition and then the block of code. Let me declare a variable I equal to 1. I can give the condition as I lesser than or equal to 5. Inside the code block, I can print the I. And one more important thing we should not forget is we need to increment the value of I inside the code block. Otherwise, the condition will never become false and so it will result in an infinite loop. When I execute this, we can see it is printing 5 times. Okay, let me change the initial I value to 7. So now it won't go inside while loop because the condition is going to be false. And so we cannot see anything. But we have another loop, do while. In the normal while loop, let me replace the while statement with do. And then at the end, let me put the while statement. Now, regardless of the condition, it will execute the do block once and then check for the condition. And if the condition is true, the loop continues till it becomes false. Otherwise, it exits. This is how while and do while works. Before we close, I need to tell one more thing. In a while loop, if we miss to increment, it will result in an infinite loop, and we need to terminate the program manually. Also, we can create an infinite while loop like this. Similarly, in a for loop, if we wrongly mention the condition, it may result in an infinite loop. So we should be careful on these. That's all about loops. If you like this video, please subscribe and support me. I'll be back with another concept soon. Thank you. Bye.